morning, Year 11. So we're revisiting what we looked at last lesson. So how many marks is paper one question four worth? What is the question going to ask you to do? And how long should you spend answering it? Give yourself 5 minutes to answer these questions. So just a quick reminder from last lesson then. So we started having a look at question four and we did quite a lot of work on how you should approach the question to begin with. So it's about evaluating the text critically, so thinking about an opinion based on the text. You will be told which lines of the extract to concentrate on. You'll be given a statement about this part of the extract and then you'll be asked to what extent do you agree with the statement. You always agree with the statement and then you have to find some quotations from the text to support your. Okay, so in the exam then, you'll be given a source just like this one on the board, on the slide at the moment, okay? You get 15 minutes in the exam to read this text in its entirety, okay? And you have to read the whole thing in order to have any chance of being successful in any of the reading section. Now, the thing to remember is even if you get a reader, they cannot read this for you, okay? So you have to work really hard on reading it yourself, okay? Now, unfortunately, this one's not very clear, and I think as it comes up on the YouTube slide, it'll probably become a little bit even more blurry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read this one through for you. So as we're reading it through, there's two things I want you to be thinking about, okay? Three things I want you to be thinking about. So the first thing I want you to think about is what is happening in this text, okay? And remember that that little box at the top, so this section up here, is designed to help you with this step, okay? It's designed to help you understand what is going on. So who seems to be the main character or main characters? So are there a couple or does it just focus on one? And then how do you they feel about what is happening to them? Okay, so you're going to need to listen really carefully because I'm going to read this out for you. And then you need to answer those three questions on your own. So the extract is from the opening of a novel by Daphne du Maurier. Although written in 1935, it is set in the past. In this section, a coach and horses with its passengers is making its way through Cornwall to Jamaica Inn. So the title is Jamaica Inn. It was a cold grey day in late November. The weather had changed overnight when a barking wind brought a granite sky and a mizzling rain with it. And although it was now only a little after 2 o'clock in the afternoon, the paler of a whiter evening seemed to have closed upon the hills, cloaking them in mist. It would be dark by four. The air was clammy cold and for all the tightly closed windows, it penetrated the interior of the coach. The leather seats felt damp to the hands, and there must have been a small crack in the roof because now and again little drips of rain fell softly through, smudging the leather and leaving a dark blue stain like a splodge of ink. The wind came in gusts, at times shaking the coach as it travelled round the bend of the road, and in the exposed places on the high ground it blew with such force that the whole body of the coach trembled and swayed, rocking between the high wheels like a drunken man. The driver, muffled in a great coat to his ears, bent almost double in his seat in a faint endeavour to gain shelter from his own shoulders, while the dispirited horses plodded sullenly to his command, too broken by the wind and the rain to feel the whip that now and again cracked above their heads, while it swung between the numb fingers of the driver. The wheels of the coach creaked and groaned as they sank into the ruts of the road, and sometimes they flung up the soft splattered mud against the windows, where it mingled with the constant driving rain, and whatever view there might have been on the countryside was hopelessly obscured. The few passengers huddled together for warmth, exclaiming in unison when the coach sank into a heavier rut than usual, and one old fellow who kept up a constant complaint ever since he had joined the coach at Truro rose from his seat in a fury and, fumbling with the window sash, let the window down with a crash, bringing a shower of rain upon himself and his fellow passengers. He thrust his head out and shouted up to the driver, cursing him in a high, petulant voice for a rogue and a murderer, that they would all be dead before they reached Bodmin if he persisted in driving at breakneck speed. They had no breath left in their bodies, as it was, and he, for one, was never going to travel by coach again. Whether the driver heard him or not was uncertain. It seemed more likely than the stream of reproaches was carried away in the wind, for the old fellow, after waiting a moment, put up the window again. Having thoroughly chilled the interior of the coach and setting himself once more in his corner, wrapped his blanket around his knees and muttered in his beard. His nearest neighbour, a jovial red-faced woman in a blue cloak, sighed heavily in sympathy, and with a wink to anyone who might be looking and a jerk of her head towards the old man, she remarked for at least the 20th time that this is the dirtiest night she ever remembered, and she had known some, that it was proper old weather and no mistaking it for summer this time. And burrowing into the depths of a large basket, she brought out a great hunk of cake and plunged into it with strong white teeth. Mary Ellen sat in the opposite corner, where the trickle of rain oozed through the crack in the roof. Sometimes a cold drip of moisture fell upon her shoulder, which she brushed away with impatient fingers. She sat with her chin cupped in her hands, her eyes fixed on the window, splashed with mud and rain, hoping with a sort of desperate interest that some ray of light would break the heavy blanket of sky and put a momentary trace on that lost blue heaven that had mantled Helford yesterday's shine for an instant as a forerunner of fortune. So just give yourself 10 minutes now to go back through that text. So what is happening in the text? Who seems to be the main character or main characters, and how do they feel about what they're experiencing? Okay then, so you should have given yourself some time now to read back through the text and answer those three questions, okay? And all we're going to do for this lesson is just focus on the text, what it's talking about, who the main characters are, and how they feel about what is happening to them, okay? So to start off with, this bit at the top here should have helped you in knowing what is happening. So basically, in this section, a coach and horses with its passengers is making its way through Cornwall to the Jamaica Inn. So what is happening in this text? So they're travelling by coach to Cornwall. Okay. So obviously we know this is set in the past. It's set in the 19th century. Okay. And travelling by coach and horse, so basically a carriage and horse, would have been the only mode of travel that they would have had. If we think about Cornwall, it's around about a 6-hour drive, I think, nowadays. So you imagine travelling by coach, which is much slower than car. Obviously it would take them quite a few days to get there. All right. So who seems to be the main characters or main character? There's quite a few main characters, I would say, in this, so they kind of group them together. So the first insight we get into the characters is that the few passengers were huddled together for warmth, okay? And then it kind of breaks them down into a little bit more depth. So they think about the old fellow who had kept up a constant complaint ever since he had joined the coach, okay? And he sticks his head out the window and complains to the driver that obviously it's an uncomfortable ride and that he's not happy with how the journey is going. We then are introduced to his nearest neighbour, so the person who sat next to him, a jovial red-faced woman in a blue coat. So she seems to be disappointed by the man who sticks his head out the window. She winks at anyone who sees her and looks over at the man like, oh, look at him making a joke out of himself, okay? And obviously she seems to keep remarking that this is one of the worst weather conditions she's ever seen. But then she brings out a great hunk of cake and it makes her feel better. And then Mary Ellen is a little bit different. So she's the first one who was introduced by name. So the others are introduced by their characteristics. Mary Ellen is introduced by name. Okay, and again, we can see that obviously she's got the unfortunate spot of being under the drip. And it also introduced to us, obviously, that she is looking for a break of sunshine that she saw in Helford before she left. So for me, it's kind of already setting up that Mary might be our main character since they've named her, whereas the other characters are just described through their actions. So the answer to this one is who seems to be the main character or main characters. So Mary Ellen seems to be the main character, whilst the other characters seem to also be, you know, important in this part of the text, but they might not continue to be important throughout the rest of the text. And then finally, how do they feel about what is happening? Well, we know that the old man is very unhappy with what is happening, don't we? He's shouting out to the driver saying that he's driving and he's going to kill them all. The old lady, the red-faced lady, she seems to obviously be bothered by it because she keeps commenting on the fact that it's the dirtiest night she's ever seen. And then we know that Mary Ellen is obviously upset by what is happening because she's looking out the window, hoping, desperate to see some sort of light in this terrible condition, in these terrible conditions. So this is the text that we're going to use in our next couple of lessons. And this is the text that we're going to concentrate answering a question four piece on. So what I want you to make sure that you've got for this lesson is I want you to make sure that you have listened to the reading of the text. You need to have listened to the whole reading. And I want you to make sure that you have answered these three questions, please, in your books in full sentences. These are important. You are going to need them for next lesson.